Kino Recaps presenting the Amityville Horror. Spoiler ahead, watch out and take care. The movie starts, and we see a time, November 1974, with the appearance of a house known as Amityville. A man was sitting in the basement of that house, and a devilish voice told him to end them at 3:15 a.m. As that voice said, he picks up the gun and ends all his family. The police discover this and arrest him, but he says in his statement, "I heard few voices that night, and they make me do this." After it, we see a family in which there was a couple and three kids. In that couple, the wife was named Kathy. This is her second husband. Now they have to buy a new house, so they go to a dealer, and she shows them the house we saw at the start. The house where the man ended his family named Amityville, and it was large and inexpensive, so they decided to buy it. Meanwhile, the dealer tells them about this house's past, that there have been many murderers. But hearing this, Kathy's husband George says, "What is the fault of the house in this? The house doesn't end anyone, but people do. They buy this house while thinking to live nicely with their family." After a few days, that family comes to live in that house, and Kathy goes to make her son sleep. Her son wasn't feeling sleepy because he was missing his real father. That's why he asks Kathy, "Will George will love us like our real father?" On it, she says yes, why not? Just do friendship with him. George hears all this, so he decides to be a good father. Later, he moves to his room, but he was feeling cold, so he moves to the basement to turn the heater on. He sees a clock on which it was striking 3:15, and at the same time, he hears a few voices. He ignores those voices and moves upstairs, but George sees a girl's soul in his room when they were sleeping. She was hanged and injured badly, and this makes him scared. Kathy moves to her daughter's room, but gets shocked to see that her daughter was talking to someone. So she asks, "With whom you are talking?" On it, she says, "I am talking to Jodie. She was actually the younger sister of that man, and he ended her in this room." Her soul was wandering in this room that was just visible to Kathy's daughter. George was cutting wood, and Kathy's son brings an iron weapon to him and says, "I found it from the basement." But George becomes angry and say, "The basement is my office, and there is my important stuff. So if you will go there again, it will not be good." And that boy moves to his mother while weeping. After a while, they were not finding their daughter, so they become worried. Meanwhile, they hear a dog barking in the boathouse, and they move there. Boathouse is actually a room near the stream in which boats are kept. They see their daughter standing in the boat and was about to jump in the water, but George stops her from doing this. Kathy asks, "What is she doing here alone?" She replies, "Jodie is my friend, and I come here to show her my boathouse." Kathy feels weird hearing this, but she ignores and leaves with her daughter. After it, George leaves while locking the boathouse. Their younger son goes to the washroom at midnight, and he hears weird, terrible voices, and a soul is shown behind him when he was washing his hands. It was looking terrible, and there was blood instead of water in the tap, and the boy gets scared to see this. His condition gets worse, that's why he rushes back to his bed. Now as it strikes 3:15 at night, all the windows of the house open automatically. George awakes being surprised, and he wasn't feeling good, that's why he goes to kid's room to check. There he finds himself having a gun in his hand and ends himself the next moment with a bullet. Meanwhile, George awakes and we discover this was just a dream of George. And he sees the door of the boathouse open, even he locked it. And he feels maybe Kathy's daughter went there again. He immediately goes to check, but the girl wasn't there and his dog starts barking. On it, George feels maybe she has jumped in the water. That's why he also jumps. He didn't find her anywhere, and coming out of water, he sees Kathy's daughter seeing him through her room's window. There was a soul of a stranger girl behind her. He panics to see this and moves to her room. But he becomes astonished to see Kathy's daughter in sound sleep. The next day, George goes to the basement and sees his dog digging behind the wall, and he understands there is something. Meanwhile, Kathy arrives and asks, "Are you fine?" George says, "I can't sleep properly, and I am not in a good mood," and also becomes furious at Kathy. She feels strange seeing his changing behavior. When she was alone in the kitchen, a shadow passes behind her, and she feels someone pass from there. But when she sees on the fridge, it was written in alphabets, "Catch them and kill them." Seeing this, she feels maybe George had done this, and when she moves to ask him, in return, the alphabets take their positions back, and seeing it, Kathy think it may be my delusion. They were going to dinner at night, and they called a babysitter for taking care of kids. And the kids like her. After her arrival, Kathy was about to take her to show the whole house, but she refused. She says, I have done a babysitter job here before. I took care of the kids of the family who lived here. Later, George and Kathy go to a hotel where they spent quality time. On another side, the babysitter was telling Kathy's son about the house, that the old owner Jody's brother heard voices from this house that tell him to kill his family. Firstly, he ended his dog and later, all his family, because he believed that they were all devils. After telling this, she goes to the room of Kathy's daughter and tells this was the room of a girl named Jodie. She was killed by her brother and later, her dead body was found from the cupboard. Kathy's daughter says that Jodie told me that you were a bad babysitter. If the babysitter says she is dead, then how could she say this? And the girl doesn't reply to it. Kathy's son challenges her to go to that cupboard, but as the babysitter goes inside, Jodie's soul scares her. The soul was injured as there was a bullet mark on her forehead. She pushed her finger in her wound, and this makes her frightened. Her condition gets worse. She gets into a deep trauma, and seeing her condition, the kids call the ambulance. Meanwhile, George and Kathy return and get shocked to see the condition of the babysitter. She tells Kathy that she saw Jodie in the house, and Kathy understands that her daughter also called this name. It means there is something in the house, but George says maybe the kids have made fun with her. He scolds them, but Kathy goes to her daughter and asks what happened when we left. On it, her daughter tells that Jodie scared the babysitter as she doesn't like her. And mother, let me tell you one more thing. Jodie says George is also not a good man. The next day, George was cutting wood and seemed angry. He asks Kathy's son to place all the cut wood. There were a lot of woods, so the night appear, and Kathy's son gets tired. Kathy was angry with him because of his act. George hears Kathy's kids' voices from the basement, and they were abusing him. Along with it, he hears a terrible devilish voice asking George to kill them, and he panics hearing that voice. He moves behind the wall, and there he sees a long ditch of blood. Moving forward, he sees himself soaked in blood. Seeing it, George wakes up being shocked, and we discover this was just his dream. After it, he goes to the washroom to take a shower. But when he was bathing, a soul tries to drown him in the water. He gets scared and tries to escape, but Kathy comes and saves him, then takes him to the doctor the next day for a checkup. The doctor prescribes him a few tests, but their reports were normal. That means George is fine. Doctor said if they want, they can visit a famous psychiatrist. They get shocked when they reach home to see their daughter standing on the roof and moving towards the lake. They panic to see this and immediately move to save her. Kathy asks, what are you doing here? Where are you heading to? Her daughter replies, Jodie asked me to go with her and she will make me meet with my father, and jumps. George holds her before she falls in the water, and her life saved. Now because of this, Kathy becomes furious at her. George feels their acts are strange. He calls them mad and moves to the basement with his luggage to live there. After it, Kathy goes to a church father and tells him everything is happening weirdly because there is an evil power in my house. My house is scattered because of it. The father becomes worried hearing this and says there was the same case I held a year ago. Kathy asks, was this the case of the man who killed his family, including a girl named Jodie? On it, the father says yes, but how do you know all this? Kathy replies, because we are living in their house right now. George's behavior was changed in the house. He beats Kathy's son. Then he moves to the basement and starts watching the video of his family in which he sees Kathy's son as a devil. He becomes astonished to see this, but he sleeps after a while. Then he awakes right 3:15 at night. And he again hears the devilish voice saying kill them. Along with it, all the doors of the house open automatically. George moves to the boathouse with an axe, and reaching the boathouse, a soul attacks him. To escape, he attacks the soul with the axe and kills it, but when he comes to his senses, he doesn't find any soul there. He ended his dog. The next day, Kathy says we have to leave this house, as this is a haunted house. George refuses to leave this house, and they fight on this. Meanwhile, their kids arrive and tell their mother the dog is missing. They think George has disappeared the dog, or he has killed it, so they ask him about it. Now the father comes their home at noon and sees a black teddy in the hands of Kathy's daughter and tells Kathy that is Jodie's teddy, but surprisingly it was buried with her in the coffin. Then know how your daughter got it. Saying this, the father moves inside the house and puts holy water everywhere in the house. The water disappears as it falls there, and a flock of flies attacks the father the next moment. He also hears a devilish voice asking him to escape from there. And the father does the same. George awakes again at night. The devilish voice again asks him to end everyone. The voices echoing in his brain were terrible, and he was in pain, so he comes out and lay down there to avoid them. Kathy has also seen his condition, so she goes to the library the next day and starts reading the newspaper, having information about this house. She discovers Jody's brother seemed his family devil. That's why he ended his family after 28 days. And she also sees a book printed in this newspaper. A magician's name was written on it. Later, she finds it and starts reading. It was written that the magician was cruel, and he made that house in 1671, and he performed different devilish magic on people. After it, he oppresses them, and then ends them for sacrificing to devil. Then one day the magician sacrificed himself so that his soul will be imprisoned in this house forever. Seeing it, Kathy discovers there is that magician's soul in the house, making George do all this. The voices were still teasing George, so he breaks the basement door. And moving inside, he sees a jail where he used to perform magic on people, sacrificed them after oppressing them. Moving forward, he also sees that magician who cuts his neck in front of him, and his blood falls on George. This makes him possessed by the magician, who has now become a devil. Later, Kathy goes to the father's house and asks, why did he run from their house? On it, the father tells her there is a terrible and powerful soul in their house. I couldn't fight with it, so I ran. Kathy returns home after it and sees George in a weird condition in the boathouse. He also tries to end Kathy while attacking her, but she runs from there. Kathy's daughter sees the coffins of the names of her family members when she goes to the basement. She gets scared to see them and also shows this to Kathy. After it, they decide to leave the house. Now the possessed George was finding his family while having a gun, and the soul of the magician helps him. He shuts all the doors and windows of the house so that they couldn't run from there. They move to the house roof while breaking the window, but George was chasing them and Kathy's son hits him a rod. He falls down and gets faint immediately. They come down and try to escape from there. Meanwhile, George stands up and stabs Kathy an axe, but she somehow picks up the gun and attacks George. This makes him faint, and after it, they place George in the boat while tying him and leave. George awakes after a while and asks Kathy leave as soon as possible and don't stop. After it, it was written on the screen that it's been 28 days that family was living there, but they left the house and never returned. Later, Jody's soul is shown pulled by the magician's soul into the basement. Along with it, the things of the house come to their normal condition, which means any family will come here and will be the prey of this magician, then another family will come after their death, and so on. The magician will end everyone and will make them his prey, will keep on sacrificing to the devil. Actually, he has become a devil, and this house is haunted by him because he worships the devil and sacrifices people for the devil. But then one day he sacrificed himself to stay in this house as a soul forever. He used to possess the men of the house and made them end their families. Now he was getting power while doing this. He wants to rule here. But this, the movie ends. Please support us with your subscribe and turn on the bell notification.